Sông Trình Quỳ. Sông Trình Lục Mì Thủy Cà Pi Lục Nôn Chía, Món To Sông Nùa.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Good afternoon, Your Honour.
During the lunch break, we had the opportunity to listen to the audio recording of your DC-10 interview. And if everything goes well technically, shortly we will be
We will have that played in the scoreroom so that you can hear back what you said in relation to
that secret document
that we spoke about before the break.
In the audio recording, you do say that you yourself
reflection
saw the Before technically everything is in order, let me continue with my questions from before the break,
Mr. Witness.
We were talking
about...
Thank you. Before Council starts his questions, can I ask for the E3 reference of the audio tape that Council is referring to?
Apparently there is no E3 number, it's just on record known as the audio recording of that particular DC number, so there's no E3. At least that's what I've been told.
You will make a request for the record.
But because of my time, I want to ask other questions first. So let me see
how far I will go.
Let me read to you what a fellow combatant said about UN. That is E3/2073. English year end Fine, thank you, Mr. Witness. Let me move on to the next subject. Before the lunch break, we spoke about the arrest of Un, and we talked about he or him being invited with others to the Chinese embassy. Maybe it was in Korean, we don't know for sure. But let me read to you what you said subsequently in relation to his arrest, B3/75-23, English ear N008-75577, Khmer 0006 1166, French 0008-84-2-3435. You said yes, it was the Chinese embassy. Question: was he invited to welcome the Chinese ambassador? And then you say no, it was a lie. Then, oh, I see. When he traveled there, he was arrested. Did Khmer Rouge soldiers point their rifles at him? And then you said, yes, rifles were pointed at him from all directions. Was it at Wat Phnom? It was west of Wat Phnom. Do you recall saying this, Mr. Witness? And if yes, did you see that with your own eyes, or was it something that you heard?
But Kim, at Ban Kern, the Louis King J.
Do you know who was arrested first?
I looked down in an aki, Chap Kloon Mon Koytun, Miracle, maybe Chica Un.
But Kim Dante, the Un Moody, Kitchap, Dungan Amon Nagro, Ban Dunk.
Let me see if I can refresh your memory on that very same page. Right following your answer, you say, to the question, was Un arrested before Koytun or vice versa? And your answer is as follows. Koytun was arrested before Un, but they were arrested at almost the same time. The Khmer Rouge did not let one of the traitors escape. I believe that if the plot had been implemented, not so many people would have been killed. So is it correct what you say here, Mr. Witness, that Koytun was arrested before Commander Un?
But Ban Luki Yaja Eng, the Jap Koy Kun Mon and Un Groy. When it had Ban Kun Pnik, Ban Kun Ti Ban.
I understand. Did you hear about Koytun's arrest? You heard about Un being arrested at the Chinese embassy. Do you know how, when, and where Koytun was arrested?
ไอ้การจํานวนนั้นเนาะគ្មានណាបៀតក្លែងគេបានទីគេអ្នកធំធំណាក់តូចតូចនេះដូចខ្ញុំអត់មានហេតុបៀតទេបាទ
Well, let me nevertheless see if I can jog your memory a bit. You earlier mentioned Prime Minister Hun Sen. We have evidence from a fellow 310 combatant saying that Hun Sen Let me give the exact quote.
Then GMP Honsan, Kim Sol, Dr. Strong,
Ben Kinnan. In document E3/1593 on English page 25 of the book, English ERN 0101 6 9 1 0 2 0 6 3 7 8 9 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 Prime Minister Hun Sen says that Khoi Thun was arrested, was placed, I apologize, was placed, quote unquote, under house arrest near the Independence Monument, end of quote. Is that something you heard? As Prime Minister Hun Sen says, placed under house arrest in a house near Independence Monument. Well, that might very well be true, because there is also another account of Khoi Thun's arrest. Maybe that is something that potentially could jog your memory. That is a document about Division 703, English ERN 0001 8 4 4, no French, only Khmer 0012 9 7 5. Who was assigned to arrest Khoi Thun. Who was, according to the author, residing north of Wat Phnom. Quote, it took 2 days and a night before it was possible to arrest Khoi because of the many soldiers guarding him. The forces that were to make the arrest were mixed, some from the 704th Battalion and some from the General Staff, and were deployed from the front of the railroad station all the way to Wat Phnom. End of quote. Could that be correct, Mr. Witness, that Khoi Thun was residing north of Wat Phnom, and that it took 2 days and a night before it was possible to arrest him, and that many soldiers were needed?
How
about Khoi Thun residing north of Wat Phnom? You yourself stationed close to Wat Phnom at one point? Did you know whether Khoi Thun was residing under house arrest close to Wat Phnom?
I was in Wat Phnom, but I didn't see it. គាត់ធូននៅក្បែរនោះសោះអត់បាទ
Now let me talk about dates.
ឥឡូវនេះខ្ញុំនឹងពិភាក្សាអំពីការបរិច្ឆេទវិញម្ដងខ្ញុំនឹងថាវាពិបាកប៉ុន្តែ
Mr. Witness
លោកសាក្សី
Un seems to have been arrested
អឿនប្រហែលជាត្រូវបានគេចាប់ខ្លួន
17th of, or 18th of February 1977
ថ្ងៃ17/18កុម្ភៈ77
Un seems to have been arrested
ហើយគាត់ប្រហែលជាត្រូវបានចាប់ខ្លួនដែរថ្ងៃ25 មករា 77
Could that be the case?
តើវាអាចទេ?
Un's visit to the Chinese embassy in and around February 77.
អឿនគាត់ទៅស្ថានទូតចិននៅប្រហែលជាក្នុងខែកុម្ភៈឆ្នាំ1977
ខ្ញុំជិះលោកចក្រមចង់មក
Oui.Maître Copé, est-ce que vous pouvez me donner
les dates d'arrestation, les dates de l'arrestation, Well, it's obviously in the S21 documents, but it's also referenced in
Kennan.
With your leave, let me get back to that, but it's
reference in
Chandler
and in Keenan,
both believe 21st of January for Khoi
Thun.
There are records of arrest for Un in February. Mr. Witness, the arrest of Un...
តើការចាប់ខ្លួនអឿន
Chinese embassy
នៅស្ថាន
ទូត February 77
អាចទេវានៅក្នុងខែកុម្ភៈឆ្នាំ77
កាលនោះវាមិនសូវដឹងខេណាខេណាទេខ្ញុំមិនសូវស្គាល់ខេណាខេណីទេគិតទីខ្លាចភ័យខ្លាចភ័យអត់មានដឹងថាថ្ងៃនេះខេណាខេណីអត់ដឹងផងអត់បានចាំផងបាទ
I understand. Let me now go back to the plans.
As you put it,
to destroy Pol Pot plan, as you call it, topple
Pol Pot.
When was this plan to topple or destroy Pol Pot supposed to be taking place to be effectuated? Have you heard anything about this?
ឬថាគេប្រុងអនុវត្តផែនការនឹងនៅថ្ងៃខែឆ្នាំណាដែរ
បាទអត់មានឮគេថាថ្ងៃណាថ្ងៃនេះខែណាខែនេះទេអត់មានឮទេបាទ
Let me try it differently.
In
your DC Chem statement, you said that the plot was disclosed.
People
found out about the plot.
How much time was there between you
seeing
those
paratroopers uniforms
and those weapons and
the day that Un was arrested
ថ្ងៃដែលគេចាប់ខ្លួនអឿននឹងតើចន្លោះពីពេលដែលលោកឃើញកៅប៉ារ៉ារហូតដល់ថ្ងៃគេចាប់អឿននោះមានរយៈពេលប្រហែលប្រមាណដែរ
បាទឃើញកលែងគេរៀបខោអាវប្រហែលជាក្លាស់ខែមុនប្រហែលជា15ថ្ងៃគេចាប់ខ្លួនគេបាទ
អឺ So about September 76, would that be possible?
ចឹងអាចទេក្នុងខែកញ្ញាឆ្នាំ76.
បាទខ្ញុំអត់បានចាំទេព្រោះសម័យនោះវាអត់មានស្លង់សញ្ញាមានអីណាអត់មានដឹងចាំអីទេ
Now, Mr. Witness, there is quite some evidence as to when exactly this plot was supposed to be taking place and the rebellion was supposed to be taking place. Just for the record, referring again to Keenan, Vice President E/1593. English At a September 1976 meeting in Odom, Chi Province, north of Siem Reap, Khoi Thun and Sot had planned a coup in Phnom Penh for 1 January 1977. A radio station was set up in Odom, Chi to broadcast the appeal for a general uprising. Another report says the mutiny had been planned for 17 April 1977.
នឹងគឺធ្វើក្រុងធ្វើនៅថ្ងៃ17មេសាចិត្ត7
ប៉ុន្តែមេធាវីក្នុងពេលដែលលោកអានដូច្នេះ
តើលោកអាចប្រាប់បានទេថាគាត់អាចទៅលើផ្ទះតាំងអីសរសេរបែបនេះមេធាវីគឺគាត់យោងទៅលើ
footnote 147
147ការសម្ភាសន៍របស់ប៉ុងឈូជាមួយនឹង
Cadre, who had escaped, and in footnote 148, he refers to Asia Week article of 2 December 1977. While I'm at it, I might add, we have requested a document to be admitted in a recent request, a December request, we filed on the 30th of August 2016, document E434. This particular publication is on the case file and known as F2/8.129. I'm sorry, Mr. President, I will do it again. I said, while I'm at it, there's another publication that we have requested to be admitted. It is known as part of document request, H7 request E434. It's on the case file now as F2/8.1.29. It has an English ERN only, 0114-1796. That places the rebellion or the coup d'etat on the 20th of January of 1977. There's also evidence which I'm not at liberty to discuss, but that would indicate that the rebellion was supposed to take place on the 15th of March.
If you're not at liberty to discuss it, I suggest you don't read it into the case file.
Our position, 15th of March, that is at least the date that I want to mention. So,
Mr. Witness, all kinds of dates that the rebellion or the plan to topple or destroy the deportation court was supposed to take place. Is it correct somewhere between January and April 1977?
bạn khi mà để bạn đăng thì nếu cả nó rừng thư phèn ca phèn ơi bọc thì cứ ở bạn đăng vào.
Let me see if I can try it
differently.
Try it differently. You said earlier
something you also said
in your DC Chem statement.
I look about the one point in time,
Southwest Zone forces came to take over the command.
And
you and other combatants
were
required to listen to confessions of Un
and
potentially others. During that meeting, and I'm not talking about the actual confessions, but during that meeting, did you hear anyone say when this coup d'etat was supposed to take place?
គេអត់មានយាយពីរឿងធ្វើរដ្ឋប្រហារទេគឺយាយទៅពីរឿងចាប់ខ្លួនតើអឿនទៅប៉ុណ្ណោះបាទហើយយុទ្ធជនខាងភូមិភាគដកម្មាភិបាលយុទ្ធជននៅសល់កុំយកតម្រាប់តាមតើអឿនទៅប៉ុណ្ណោះទេតែរឿងបញ្ហាធ្វើរដ្ឋប្រហាររត់អុយគឺអត់មានដឹង
Mr. President, this might be a
appropriate moment to
request
formally.
To have this very particular excerpt from the audio recording of the DC interview played in the courtroom
and hopefully we will be able to hear exactly
I don't have any objection to the audio being used, but it needs to be part of the evidence. Again, our request is not to have it admitted, just to play out in court. And when we hear the conversion, there will be an English translation, and then it becomes part of the record, and that's all that we are
submitting. You can only use something, this is very technical, but you can only use something in court which has been
submitted.
Well, actually,
I recently read the
Le président, la Chambre déclare donc recevable l'enregistrement sonore.
en question.
Juste, pouvez-vous nous redonner la cote pour que cela soit versé dans le pot
dossier? La défense. Drive,
sur le répertoire partagé, c'est le cas T
I 08 18 18. And it is the excerpt that we will be reading.
L'extrait que nous allons lire
is Khmer page.
Maître, veuillez patienter. Il semblerait qu'il y ait un problème avec le matériel d'interprétation.
Le
président. Maître, le système est à présent opérationnel. Vous pouvez
poursuivre.
Il semble que le problème se pose à nouveau. Veuillez patienter.
So yes, Mr. President, with your leave, I would like to play the audio excerpt, which is cross-referenced in E3/752 English 008-7574. Where he speaks about secretly reading documents, and in one document there was a plan in which the U.S. would come in and help within 24
hours.
Mr. Witness, was that your voice? Mr. President, it was indeed a bit fast with your leave. Could I request you to have it played one more time?
Some kind of chat, say, with only Madame Tilly.
មន្ត្រីសោតទួចាក់ខ្សែអត់នេះម្ដងទៀត
ពូមានឆ្ងល់ថាឯកសារមើលមិនឯកសារឯកសារគេខ្ញុំលើកមើលវិញថាផែនការអាមេរិកមកជួយឲ្យទុក24ម៉ោងខ្ញុំលើកមើលអីកណ្ដាស់នេះ
ដាក់នឹងមានសេថាជំនាញឲ្យបោះពីណា
វិញមើលមើល
មកគេសេដៃឬក៏គេវាយ
វាយនេះលេខ
លេខ
ថា
Again, my question, did you
recognize
your voice?
May the way, my dog did look at say, look, stop some lane, you're
about to look to all the band there. But some lane, you do the hand, but you can do the moon and eggs out of him, the other Korean band here, eggs are not him, run up without Dangta, band, Korean eggs are giddy.ព្រោះកាលនោះវាដូចអត់មានឯកសារឯណាច្រើនផងបាទ
So your DC camp statement មិនទៅដូចនេះចម្លើយ
របស់លោកជំឆ្លើយទូជាមួយនឹងមជ្ឈមណ្ឌលឯកសារកម្ពុជានេះគឺថាមិនត្រឹមត្រូវទេអញ្ចឹងគឺខ្ញុំមិន
បាទខ្ញុំវាឮដូចសំឡេងខ្ញុំដែរប៉ះនេះកាលដែលមានឯកសារនននិយាយដឹងឯកសារដឹងអុយគឺថាដូចទីដែលមានឯកសារអីអុយបើខ្ញុំគ្រាន់តែឃើញគេរៀបចំខោអាវអាវុធអុយគឺឃើញមែនដល់បានឃើញឯកសារនោះដូចអត់ដែលបានឃើញសោះបាទមិនដែលបានឃើញទេនេះយេពិតមកត្រង់
Very well.
Mr.
Witness, before I move back to what happened with
Vietnamese troops while you were in Vietnam,
Mae Mot,
let me ask you
some last question in relation to the plot or the coup d'etat attempt. You talked about uniforms, weapons, boots,
you
gave some other examples. Did you ever hear about plans to attack and seize Pochintong Airport to take control of the airport in relation to the coup d'etat attempt
តកតងទៅនឹងគោលបំណងនៃការធ្វើរដ្ឋប្រហារនេះដែរឬទេ
បាទខ្ញុំបាទអត់ឲ្យបានឮគេនិយាយអុយទីរឿងធ្វើផែនការផែនអុយនោះខ្ញុំអត់ដែលដឹងពីបញ្ហាផែនការរបស់គេទីដោយការជំនឿនោះដូចដឹងស្រាប់គេនធំគឺគេដឹងតែគ្នាគេទេអត់ទូចទូចគេដែលឲ្យយើងដឹងគេមិនដែលឲ្យយើងដឹងទេបាទព្រោះមានផែនការអុយក៏គេបញ្ជាទៅប៉ុណ្ណោះអីបើថាអោយគេអោយដឹងគឺគ្មានបាទអត់មានអោយដឹងខ្ញុំអស
់Just to be to avoid any confusion, I'm talking about the same plot that you referred to, the weapons and the uniforms that you saw. Have you ever heard that they were supposed to be used for soldiers who were supposed to attack and seize, take control of Pochintong Airport?
ខ្ញុំមិនដែលបានលឺហើយបាទខ្ញុំថាខ្ញុំអត់ដែលបានលឺគេថាវាយកតំណែងយកពូចិនតុងណាដែលបានលឺទីបាទ
well let me read to you testimony from a Division 310 combatant who was about your same position as you were, a bit higher maybe, English ERN 008-76520. Khmer 00020598, French 008926665. Sam Hoon, who testified also in this courtroom, says, we were ordered to stand by for further orders. When the time came, we were to transport these weapons onto Son Sen's place in Pochintong to attack and seize Pochintong Airport, to attack and seize an artillery and armored vehicle warehouse, and another battalion was ordered to get ready to attack the radio station. However, the plot was revealed and all involved leaders and their associates were arrested. Low-ranking Division 310 combatant who was sent to Kampuchang Airfield knew about this. Does that jog your memory? No problem. Mr. Witness, you yourself were not part of the actual coup, as I understand. But let me read one final excerpt from another Division 310 combatant. Maybe you hear things that somehow would revive your memory. D3-509, this is a WRI from a Division 310 combatant, English ERN 0028-2217, Khmer 002-70-159-60, French 002-85597-98. So let me read that to you briefly. One day, I was called to a meeting at Batnum, where Tayim, the battalion chairman, made an announcement to the combatants of Battalion 306 regarding plans to carry out a coup. He said that at 3 a.m., we would open fire and attack and take the radio station near Wat Phnom in order to make an announcement. That night, suddenly, Ta Sinun, the former Battalion 306 commander, along with Un, who was at the Ministry of Commerce at the time, Taban, and Tayim, chairman, were called by the upper echelon of the organization to a meeting and then disappeared. Bit further, do you believe there was actually a coup plan? Answer, yes, it was true. Approximately 300 combatants had attended a meeting at 4 p.m. and listened to Tayim make an announcement on the plan, and after that the weapons were ready. Does that somehow help you in your memory?
ខ្ញុំអត់មានបានដឹងឬផែនការរបស់គីទេបើនឹកឃើញបើខ្ញុំអត់បានមានការពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយគីគីនឹកឆ្លើយយកគីនឹកដឹងខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងខ្ញុំនៅតែមកក្រុមខ្ញុំនៅដែល
Khi nơi chụp năng rẽ chụp mỗi cái đằng. Và đôi khi nhóm nơi ế ca thì mà cầm xét kệ cho mấy đằng rồi. Và nhóm miên chấm lời từ bên này. Và ớt đắng chúng ta ớt đằng. Và đắng nhóm chấm lời thật đằng. Và
so the only thing that you knew was about those uniforms and weapons and
boots, correct? Yes, but when I was young, I was young. But when I was young, I was young. I was young. I was young. But I was young. I was young. Đập mùi này thì và để rừng kỳ tiết nhóm ở bàn khơi sọ và
Let me move to my final subject. Some last questions in relation to what you heard in your communication with the Vietnamese and the forces or the groups of Heng Samrin and Hun Sen. Was it part of your surveillance task, surveillance
the enemy, that you heard their communication on the
radio? I was able to get the mà tạm một chút khi ông ấy cầm ôi khi ông về Bà Hà từ lưu Việt Nam Bồ Tha bố tây khăn ông kháng khăn ông này khi xâm lập chết ở thở hơi anh trời thoi trôi tư nhóm lưu tế bà nội khi ông ở rừng một chút tuông cao nó có mình mến bậc sở rầy bậc tây khăn ông มาเพลิดมาเพลิด ยิงเบิกสไร กิจับกุมหอยิงตีน ละเฮย อาจเห็นเบิกตี เบิกตีเมียนกา ประยุทธ์คณี ไอ้นัง เมียนกาติตวงเรกา อุ้ยปะนะ บัด บาด อาจเมียนเติงเยย อุ้ย เวียนชายบานตี บาด
But did you hear this on the military channel?
ก็ปนแต่ ลูกสนับลื้อตามระยะ
กันนั้นระบบยุทธ์เทียกับปราณีหรือแอร์ดออนเดอะเวียดนามีสมิลิเตอรี่แชนเนลบ้านสนับลือโซไว้ได้อัมพีกาเตะตรงตามประจุระเบียงกองตัวเวียดนามเนี่ยขยมอัดบ้านสนับลือกี่เยี่ยขณีไปเรื่องทือสกรรมอภิเษกไม่เนื้ออัดบ้านลือตีลือตีจีขณีตัวเป็นตัวมอไปชะลอเวียดนามจอดมอก็ ที่เติร์ดดูแม่ขยมก็มันเจ๊เพียซาก็ยูนสิงตุที่โอยเติร์ดปนอเองปนอที่ลุยตามด่านติดแล้วที่ขณีปนอที่ตามด่านติดเบ็ดเติร์ดอันเห็นเยี่ยติแต่บทชิวก็เบิกสระดับขเมก็มาแดงรับลือดอกกี้ที่จับขโมยยิงเพลียมบ่า
But is my understanding correct that you heard Khmer voices on the Vietnamese military channel and that you somehow concluded or heard maybe that these Khmer voices that you heard in the Vietnamese radio belonged to Heng Samrin's or Hun Sen's troops. Is that correct?
Sorry, Councillor, perhaps I missed it, but when did he say that he thought he listened to a Vietnamese channel? My understanding was he didn't know what kind of channel he was listening to. The thing he knows was that he heard Khmer and Vietnamese voices.
Well, it's a follow-up question
ແຕ່ໂອທົມພາຈີອ້ອຍຕະມອງ3ມອງ3ລະງຽດບານເລືອມອງ3ລະງຽດຍັງລູດບາກຕາເລືອເລືອຍຍຽດຄແມ່ປານໄດ້ຂ້ອຍຍັງໄດ້ເລັກໄດ້ເລັກຄາງເວຍດນາມຍຽດເສງຕິຄາງເວຍດນາມມີວັດຊຸຕິດຕວງຕິດເສງແຕ່ຄແມ່ຄືມີວັດຊຸເສງເສງນໍກາໄທຄແມ່ລືຕາໄທລະງຽດເອອ້ອຍຕະມອງ3ມອງ4 ເຈງມອງມັນຕູ້ໃຫ້ມັນຕູ້ໂຕກໍບັດໂຕແຕ່ປານໃດອັນນີ້ຂ້ອຍຍິດໄດ້ແລ້ວແນ່ເວຍນາມນູ້ເສງໂຕຕິດຕວງຈອມເວຍນາມເບິກຕິດຈອມເວຍນາມກໍຍຽດຊຸມເວຍນາມຊ້ອງນີ້ຊຸມເວຍນາມໂຕແຕ່ເບິກຈອມຄແມກໍຍຽດຄແມມາຕູ້ໂຕກໍລຸຍແບດໂຕອັນຮຽນເບິກຢູ່ບາດ
But did you hear voices belonging to Heng Samrin's and Hun Sen's troops
on that Vietnamese channel,
or was it somehow related to the Vietnamese channel? I'm still not sure if I do understand.
And again,
for me, it isn't clear that it was a Vietnamese channel. I wonder if he knows at all which channel he was listening to. Perhaps that's the easiest question to ask. You heard Khmer voices and Vietnamese voices. Do you know which channel you heard these voices?
Pesa Vietnam, mền thế hay lư nâng lư nô lư cần nal nô lư phải con khóc nia mền thế.
Bạn khóc nia đôi khi ông thả đôi lệ thì khóc nia. Khmer gì? Sì. Vietnam, thing, but.
But what were these Khmer voices saying? Were they saying that, were they requesting Khmer troops to walk over to the other side?
To the Vietnamese?
บาดเกริ่นนี้គេនិយាយអំពីមនុស្សប្រាប់មកខាងខ្ញុំមិនថាឈប់តស៊ូទៅដូចខ្ញុំបាននិយាយហើយថាឈប់តស៊ូទៅទលាក់វត្តទៅកុំណែខ្មែរមេអើយខាងក្រោយនោះគេយកទៅសម្រាប់ចូលហើយហើយចូលរួមគ្នាតស៊ូទៅ ដើម្បីវាកំចាត់នោះឯងខ្ញុំលឺទីប៉ុណ្ណោះឯងមិនថាដឹងទីហ៊ុនសែនដឹងទីពីណាទីប៉ិនខ្មែរគឺឬខ្មែរមែនខ្ញុំចាប់បានសម្លេងនឹងទេអូធំទេអូនោះផេលសេសែ6លូវូចាប់ចុចលូវូអឺទេអូមួយមួយកាត់គប់បាត់ដាច់បាត់ទៅណាបាទ
Let me see if I can try to pin you down a bit more in terms of time. Mr. President, I'll be referring to Keenan's book again, E3/1593, Khmer 0 6 7 8 2 6 till 2 7 French 0 6 3 9 1 5 4
So I'm going to be reading this excerpt and ask you whether what I have described is something, could be something that you might have heard. Keenan is quoting an informant saying the following. On 22nd December, two Vietnamese tanks drove into Kandal Chirum Township in an attempt to contact Sopim. Then they turned back towards the border. Inside the tanks, it appears, were several Khmer revolutionaries who had previously fled to Vietnam. Hem, H-E-M, Samin, S-A-M-I-N, and eight others accompanied the Vietnamese forces on missions across different sections of the border. Samin managed to penetrate into Svalin province dressed in black with a squad of 10 bodyguards. He heard people's grievances, but leading cadres were nowhere to be seen. He tried to make contact, but I hope it's a long quote. I hope you were able to understand this quote. These voices that you heard, these Khmer voices, were these attempts by other Khmer revolutionaries joined by Vietnamese forces to ask you and others to go to the other side,
Vietnamese side?
ខ្មែរនោះចុចទៅមកក៏អោយរូបរួមគ្នាចូលពុតដៃគ្នាវាលំលំវាប្រហាទៅលើប៉ុលពតអីបាទប៉ានេះខ្ញុំក៏មិនជឿអត់ជឿទេនៅតិចតិចប្រឆ្លោះនោះឯងខ្ញុំអត់ដឹងថាគេតស៊ូអុយមានទីអត់ដឹងដែរ มันได้ขมัยในเวียดนามเองปนอยខ្ញុំដឹងប្រាប់ប្រកខ្ញុំនៅទីក្នុងព្រៃតាំងពីទៅព្រំដែនមិនដែលបាននៅវាលទីទេនៅទីក្នុងព្រៃមកក្រុមនៅក្នុងព្រៃទៅមិត្តតៀងតាណាក៏នៅតោះហើយបើថាឲ្យដឹងរឿងគេពីចេះមួយចោះពីគឺមានអត់ដឹងទេដឹងទេថា ពេលវាយគ្នាក៏ស្ដាប់ល្បាយកាលបុះប្រមាណលັບប្រមាណបាទខ្វាំងចូលពីខាងនេះពីខាងនោះហើយប្រាប់យុទ្ធជនថាគេពឹតពីក្រោយពីមុខអានោះស្ដាប់ពីផែនការនោះឯងតែរឿងការស្ដាប់រឿងការតស៊ូតអុយគឺអត់ដែលបានដឹងទីបាទរឿងថារីកាទៅពីរឿងថា ទៀនລັບប្រមាណលបុះប្រមាណអស់គ្រឹបអស់អុយអានោះគឺប្រកាសប្រជាមែនបើថារឿងការស្ដីណានេះគឺអត់មានដឹងទេបាទនៅដូចសัตว์ក្នុងព្រៃមូសខំយប់យប់គឺមិនដឹងរឿងគេទេអត់ដឹងទេបាទ
Thank you for that clarification, Mr. Witness. Two very final small questions. We had a witness recently testifying in this chamber, Mr. Witness, talking about soldiers stationed at Troy Chang Hoa, where you were stationed, Troy Chang Hoa Bridge. That is the 1st of September 2016 at about 9:20 in the morning, Mr. President. Soldiers stealing sandals, kettles, and meals from civilians. Were you ever involved, or your unit ever involved in stealing sandals, kettles, and meals?
លួចយករបស់របរមានទឹកដោះគោស្បែកជើងអង្គរជាដើមលាក់ពីដែរឬទេ
ອັດທີກອງຂ້ອຍໃນນູອັດມີແດ່ລູຍຢູ່ສະເບຈຶງຫຼືຕະດອກຄູອ້ອຍຄມຽນດີມາກເລງນູຂ້ອຍໃນຊິບຈຸມຍກອງປົນທີ
3. And my last question in relation to that document, did you read any names of American intelligence officers in that document?
Does
the name Richard Messler
Richard Messler mean anything to you?
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, Mr.
Witness.
Some change culture.